Hello boys, welcome back to another session of video tutorials. And this session is meant for class 12th biology students. And this is for 6th February 2021. As all of us know, we are having the revision mode. And revision is taking place for the third time. And this time around, it is in the form of sample papers. Last two sessions, in fact, I had given you a sample paper 2 with a key. And now, in this session, I am going to give you a sample paper 3 based on 2021 batch. That's your batch. And what is important whenever you are answering a question paper is the time. Main thing is time management. So you need to plan. Totally, there are 4 sections. Section A, Section B, Section C and Section D. And you know, Section A is the main thing because it has got 22 marks and Section B has got 18 marks. So if you answer this objective type or short answer type, 22 plus 18, 40 marks out of 70. And then Section C, 15 marks, 3 marks, and Section D, 5 marks, 15 marks. So you need to plan. Naturally, this will consume a lot because you have to write long answer type. At least, say, 15 sentences you need to write. And maybe there will be diagram. So to draw a beautiful diagram and labeling, it takes time. So based on the length of the answer, what are the requirements in the answer, you need to plan. And my advice to you is, instead of 3 hours, you must plan for 2 hours 45 minutes. And remaining 15 minutes, you can go for review. What is the by mistake? You know the answer, but still in a hurry, you have missed the answer. So write that. Sometimes you get a flash at the last minute. So write that. So most important factor is time management. And of course, the 70 marks, how it is, I told you just now. 22 plus 18 plus 15 plus 15. And then for your batch, as I said, Section A is unique. Because it has got objective type questions, one mark questions. You got assertion and reasoning questions, which is new to you. And new brand one is case based questions. So that is the purpose why I am giving this. So you get familiarized. Remaining Section B, Section C, 2 marks, 3 marks, 5 marks, you are familiar. Okay. And there is no overall choice. All 33 questions you must answer, but the relaxation is internal choices are there, right? Now, as a biology student, you must draw neat and properly labeled diagrams. So keep the instructions always in your mind. Now, we go with the Section A. Question 1, how many spermatozoa are formed from one secondary spermatocyte? Question 2, from when the parturition signals arise, mother or fetus? Mention the main hormone involved in parturition. Question 3. A test is performed to know whether the given plant is homozygous dominant or heterozygous. Name the test and phenotypic ratio of this test for monohybrid cross. Question 4. Why is tubectomy considered a contraceptive method? Question 5, diagram based. Now there's a diagram on x-axis population growth curve, on y-axis population density. Now identify the curves. One is going up exponential, another is sigmoid, right? Identify the curves A and B shown in the graph given below. List the conditions responsible for growth patterns A and B. So this is what we call HOTS. Question 6th, mention the type of allele that expresses itself only in a homozygous state in an organism. Question 7, who had proposed the chromosomal theory of inheritance? Question 8, from which plant cannabinoids are obtained? Name any two cannabinoids. Which part of the body is affected by consuming these substances? So it comes under drugs. Question 9. Which recombinant vaccine is currently being used in the vaccination program? Recombinant vaccine, not the normal one. Okay. Question 10. Name some Indian traditional foods made of wheat, rice and Bengal gram or their products which involve use of microbes. Now, these are the 10 questions straight. One mark questions. So, your answer should be around 1 or 2 sentences at the most. Don't write stories. Question 11. Assertion and reasoning. Here you need to think. Don't directly jump to an answer. Assertion. Turner's syndrome is caused due to the absence of one X chromosome. Reason. The female suffering from Turner's syndrome is sterile, as ovaries are rudimentary along with other secondary sexual characters. Answer A, if both assertion and reason are correct. Answer B, if the assertion is correct but the reason is assertion is incorrect but the reason is correct. C, both assertion and reason are correct. D, assertion is correct but reason is incorrect. Now you have got a choice in this question number 11. Assertion. Duplicate genes are two or more genes found on different chromosomes that produce the same or nearly the same phenotypic effect in the dominant state. Reason. Duplicate genes produce the same intensity of effect even when present together. A. Both assertion and reason are correct. B. Assertion is correct but reason is incorrect. C. Both assertion and reason are incorrect. D. Assertion is incorrect but reason is correct. Question number 12, again same type. Mast cells in the human body release excessive amounts of inflammatory chemicals that cause allergic reactions. Reason. Allergens in the environment on reaching the human body stimulate mast cells in certain individuals. A. Both assertion and reason are true and reason is the correct explanation of the assertion. B. Both assertion and reason are true and reason is not the correct explanation of the assertion. C. Assertion is true statement but reason is false. D. Both assertion and reason are false. Now question 13. Assertion. UAA, nitrogenous bases, codon is the terminating codon. This is, should be TING, terminating codon. Reason. If in an mRNA, messenger RNA, the termination codon is present, the protein synthesis stops abruptly, whether the protein synthesis is complete or not. A. Both assertion and reason are true. B. Both assertion and reason are false. It should be C. Both assertion and reason are false. Maybe you can have D also. Assertion is right, reason is wrong. Next, question number 14. Assertion. More genetically different strains of rice present in India. Reason. A single species might show high diversity at the genetic level over its distributional range. A. Assertion and reason both are correct statements and reason is correct explanation for assertion. B. Assertion and reason both are correct statements but reason is not correct explanation for assertion. C. Assertion is correct statement but reason is wrong statement. D. Assertion is wrong statement but reason is correct statement. Question 15. Now this is the new pattern of question, as I told you, case-based study. The organism has various alterations for coping with extreme environment. Some able to respond through certain physiological adjustments, while others do so behavior-wise. These responses are their adaptations. Adaptations. Many adaptations have evolved over a long evolutionary time and are genetically fixed. Many desert plants have a thick cuticle on their leaf surfaces and have their stomata arranged in deep pits to minimize water loss through transpiration. In the polar seas, aquatic mammals like seals have a thick layer of fat, that is blubber, below their skin that acts as an insulator and reduces the loss of body heat. Some organisms possess adaptations that are physiological, which allows them to respond quickly to stressful situation. Now, this is the story. Now, below that questions will be there. Out of 5, you need to answer only 4, because this is a 4-mark question. Adaptation may be A, behavioral, B, morphological, C, physiological, D, all of this. Of course, you can easily guess this. Question 2. Opuntia has spine-like leaves which help in A, reducing the rate of transpiration, easy question again, B, increasing the rate of transpiration, C, increasing the rate of photosynthesis, D, reducing the rate of photosynthesis. Question 2. 3. Mammals from colder climates generally have shorter ears and short limbs to minimize heat loss. This is called Allen's rule, Burgess rule, Bourque's rule, Powell's rule. Now you know the answer? Yes, it is very easy again. 4. In the absence of an external source of water, the kangaroo rat in North American deserts is capable of meeting all its water requirements through A, its internal fat oxidation, through concentrating its urine. None of this, both A and B. Now, come to the 5th one, assertion. People in high altitude place experience altitude sickness. In fact, they experience. Okay. Now, altitude sickness is experienced due to low atmospheric pressure of high altitudes. The body does not get enough oxygen. A. Both assertion and reason are true, and reason is the correct explanation of the assertion. B. Both assertion and reason are true, but reason is not the correct explanation of the assertion. C. Assertion is true, but reason is false. D. Both the statements are false. Come to question 16. Again, case based. Out of 5 questions, you need to answer only 4. During fertilization in the plant, the pollen tube releases the 2 male gametes into the cytoplasm of Synergid. One moves towards the egg and fuse to complete syngamy. Another fuse with central cell. It involves 3 haploid nuclei. So it is termed as triple fusion. The central cell develop into ends, sperm, endosperm it is actually, and the zygote develop into an embryo. The central cell develops into endosperm, this should be O, endosperm, and the zygote develops into an embryo. The embryo develops at micropyle ends. Zygote gives rise to proembryo and subsequently to a globular heart-shaped mature embryo. The embryo of monocotyledon possesses only 1 cotyledon. Of course, that is the reason why we call it as double fertilization. 1. At the lower end, the embryonal axis has the radical and root cap enclosed in undifferentiated sheath called A. coleoptile, B. coleorhiza, C. integument, D. all of this. Question 2. The male gamete, which moves towards 2 polar nuclei located in the cell and fuse with them to produce zygote, embryo, pen, primary endosperm nucleus, none of this. 3. The cylindrical portion below the level of cotyle is hypocotyle, B. root cap, C. plumule, D. epicotyle. 4. The grass family cotyledon is called A. epicotyle, B. scutellum, C. plumule, D. radical. Now diagram based. Which of the following statement is correct for the figures given below? So he has given you A, B, C, D. By just looking at it, you understand. It's the embryo, growth of embryo. A is the globular embryo. D is the immature embryo. B. A diagram is fertilized embryo sac. C. Stage in embryo development in dicot. And B is the zygote. So, this is how you need to understand that varieties of questions will be there in section A. Now, what you do, I am giving you up to tomorrow time. Now, answer, put it in our WhatsApp group. And tomorrow, I will be giving answers for this. Have the self-check and verify in which field you are strong, which field you are to be improved. Also, identify from which chapter these 16...